This morning I want to talk to you about the pros and cons of the Boo Gray versus the Boo Whippet. I had a discussion yesterday and the guy said, and what a good point he made, that everything a Whippet can do, a Greyhound can do better. And that's a fair point, eh? Greyhounds offer more speed, more strength, and agility of the Whippet, which is its benefit, could be mitigated, especially if you're already crossing it with other breeds again. So that's true in general, but there were some points that were not addressed. Hoi Morgen, one of the Bordeaux points that I mentioned, even if your smaller lurcher, for example the Boo Whippet, does the things that Boo Gray do, but only for 60% or 70%, something like that, but if they are almost half the size and therefore much easier to feed, is also a benefit. So what I'm saying, you could, if you would select for small Boo Whippet, or you make an alternative Boo Whippet, but I'll come back to that soon, you could have half the food requirements, and you could have two of those little guys for one bigger one, and then the odds, in my guess, would favor especially the Boo Whippet. The other thing is that they said that a Boo Whippet cannot cope with foxes, whereas a Boo Gray can. I don't know why this is stated, but Whippets have a fair size on their own, and if you cross in Boo, any Boo should make short notice of a fox, in my opinion. So you could up, if that's your problem, you could up the amount of Boo, so not a quarter, but give it a full cross, something like that could be done. Of course, if that's needed, but I think the first generation Boo Whippet should be able to cope with foxes in the field easily. A Petterdale could easily dispatch of many a fox. They are significantly smaller, almost half the weight, so that gives you some attention there. And bringing in the Petterdale, I think the Petterdale Whippet might be a better cross altogether, but that's a different topic altogether as well. So let's keep it clean: Boo Gray versus Boo Whippet. Also the benefit that I mentioned, that the Whippet is more agile, can turn easier, the speed needed. The quarry that they were focusing was rabbits, but rabbits and foxes can already be addressed with Boo Whippets, in my opinion, quite easy, instead of just going the Boo Gray route, which in my opinion, especially the first cross, is an overkill. It's more for deers or hawks. Hoi hoi, even zien, ga maar. Hoi.
Dat was
een tijdje geleden dat we elkaar gezien hebben.
Ja, daarom. Iedere keer wat nieuw voor de honden. Goed
zo. Hey. Zo, hoi hoi. Kom. Dat is een grote jongen. Dat is een grote jongen.
Ja.
Hoi hoi. Ja. Kom maar, hè? Kom maar, zeg. Zo, it's the type of quarry. Yeah? The faster the quarry, the more benefit you will get out of a greyhound, of course. And I'm not dissing the greyhound at all. For me, this Bull Greys are like running mastiffs, and they are very suitable for big quarry. But I'm also not dissing the Whippet. So the Whippet is a lot smaller frame and much more active, especially also indoors. Greyhound is quite lazy, unless it is able to run, a real run, a proper run. And also the benefit of the greyhound is that because of its increased size, it could help dispatch of a fox that's not too eager to fight, whereas a whippet, a pure whippet, cannot cope with a fox. It's not that much of a warrior, not that the greyhound is that much of a warrior, but its increase in size and weight will help a lot. Huh? This is often the case also if you look at boxing or some other combat sport, even in human kind, you see that weight can have an enormous impact. Therefore, matches are at fixed weight, and if it's a lot higher than the fox, this helps a lot. But that is the reason why you add bull, to even give a greyhound even more advantage also on bigger quarry. But it's the same with the whippet. A whippet, when you enter bull into it, it should be easily be able to dispatch of a fox, especially the first cross. Often these bull lurchers are between first and quarter crosses. Also the 5/8, 3/8 parts are often seen as more like a multi-generation bull lurcher in this case. But the benefit of having the bull is that you get additional fighting capabilities, strength, and also more muscles to overpower also the stronger quarry. The speed comes from the running dog, whippet or greyhound, and the strength and fighting ability and courage comes from the bull side. So in my opinion, especially if you're, we were talking about a first generation bull whippet, which was really good at doing the work against rabbits, but in my opinion could also quite handle itself against fox. Another benefit, in my opinion, of a smaller dog, and you mentioned the drawback, the decrease in speed and also the strength will be less, of course, with a smaller dog. But in my opinion, rabbits and foxes would be fair game with this cross. And that was the quarry that was at hand. The other benefit of a smaller type of dog is easier to brush. So if there are bushes, and you could easier put your whippet cross in there instead of your greyhound cross, because that increase in shoulder height also means that there's an increase in overall body size. It's harder to wrangle through the bushes. So that could be a big benefit, especially if you're hunting for rabbits. You have a bushing dog that can also, which, because it is it has the strength of that bull in it, it can just go through quite easily. It's also not that big, so it will get stuck that easily. And you still have, if the rabbits go out of the bushes, you have the same dog that can also chase them up and kill them there. You also see this with the Podenco, which is a rabbit dog more on the mainland of Europe. They have different sizes, and especially small sizes were used as brushing dogs, had to get the rabbits out. But then they were coupled with running dogs to chase them down, the bigger Podencos. Smaller Podencos, the really small ones, have some similarities with the Jack Russell. But this could be combined in one dog, which is perfect in my opinion. Really perfect. And I think now it's also a good time to mention my preferences. So instead of the bull whippet, I would even opt for a smaller bully type lurcher. And how is that? if you want a Bull Grey, you often need a big type of dog that can handle itself against everything, big or small. Hey. Hallo. Hey. Hey, big or small, so also for hog work. Hey, deer, foxes, and what have you. Size is of preference, so you want quite a big dog, because you want to have maximum speed, maximum strength as a package deal. And you can switch to what you needed more. Even if you need more speed, you can go for a quarter bull and a three-quarter greyhound. And something in between. So that's that. That's a Bull Grey, in my opinion. And I would say that the source of bull should be American Pit Bull Terrier preference. Especially if you go a quarter, you don't have that much dog aggression. Also the first crosses, in my opinion, are settled quite well with that greyhound blood, which is quite easy around other dogs. So this could be your perfect bull greyhound. And I think a quarter of bull would be enough. So what kind of quarry, except a fox, would need more than a quarter of bull in a greyhound's frame? I think nothing. And there's also the question if a sighthound, a base dog, is the best bet of going against hogs, because there are specialist workers for that. You could also go another route to add just a yacht terrier and couple that with grey and bull and still have quite a fast frame. So if it's like a one quarter of yacht terrier, one quarter of bull, and half of greyhound, so the bull is still 25%, but the yacht terrier also brings fighting ability and is a good hunter against these type of quarries. Also an all-rounder, but a specialist against black and red wild, so foxes on the one side and on the other side, hogs. So that could be a route to go, but let's just take it easy and just say one, two breeds, American Pit Bull Terrier, 25 to 50%, greyhound 50 to 75%. That would be the perfect Bull Grey, in my opinion. And if you look at the Bull Whippet, I would rather go for a Patterdale Whippet. Why? As I mentioned, Patterdales in itself are very good at dispatching foxes and should not have trouble with it. If you add some Whippet, you will lose some of the fighting ability of these little guys, of course. But the added size will also give it more strength and more body weight to work with, which is a plus. So that could be a very good combination. And why the Patterdale? Patterdale is a hunting dog. An American Pit Bull Terrier, for example, is the best bull, source of bull. If you just look at what it could bring, but it's a fighting dog, fighting against other dogs especially. And sometimes used on hogs, but not often used on them. On foxes or rabbits or the likes, and because that's an overkill. And you could also go there, go for the route of the English Bull Terrier, because it is less dog aggressive. But that dog is not an athletic dog at all, it's more of a show dog. Some lines are still kept to work, of course it is very nice, but the real source of good bull blood would be an American Pit Bull Terrier. And you could rather have 25% American Pit Bull Terrier diluted with some other good working stock genes than go for an English Bull Terrier infusion of 50%. And I also really think that introducing Greyhound would calm down the dog aggressiveness to a fair degree with that American Pit Bull Terrier crosses. And if you even have throwbacks that look a lot like the American Pit Bull Terrier and act a lot like them, you can go for another infusion of greyhound blood to dilute it to 75% to greyhound, 25% bull, which is perfect. And the whippet, I would say go for a hunting source of bull. And if you're not going need to go to bull route, you could also go for the German Jagdterrier, which is an all-rounder hunting dog. The benefits of the German Jagdterrier is that they are faster than the Pattedale Terrier. Also, they are more of an all-rounder type of dog. And that is a benefit in this case, because especially the Ur dog is very heavy for its size, because you want to have as much strength, and strength comes often with weight, in that compact frame of that chest to wrangle through the fox holes and go in the burrows of the badgers. So that's a different selection as compared to an all-rounder who also needed to have a very good stamina on long runs against hawks or deers that were shot to track them down. So that is the benefit of the Jagdterrier. And with the Jagdterrier, I would note that I wouldn't go less than 50% in general, because otherwise, there are also drawbacks with the Jagdterrier. For their frame, they bring a lot less fighting ability as compared to the Pattedale Terrier. And also the drawback of a Jagdterrier is they are quite dog aggressive as well. And that could be settled down with whippet blood, but a whippet is more of a more of a temperamental dog in itself. Also better redder as compared to the greyhound, so that's also a benefit with the smaller type of dogs. And if you go the Pattedale route, you get a more relaxed dog also in-house, so that could be a benefit of that. Jagdterrier blood is not easy to be kept in-house, because best kept outside. Both the Pattedale and the Jagdterrier also have the benefit as compared to other sources of bull that you could choose the coat variety that you want. This comes in also comes in a long-haired version, a broken coat, and the coat that you see here with Estacado is 13 month old smooth coated. And the Jagdterrier comes with a smooth coated variety, but also a rough coated, broken coated variety. So that could help, especially if you're going the brushing route, then a little bit of extra coat will help tremendously to protect the skin against abrasions of brambles or something like that. So that could be another big benefit of going the Pattedale / Jagdterrier route. You could also combine those two, Jagdterrier and Pattedale again, and then couple it to a whippet to lose the dog aggression if not needed. And also slow it down in-house, but add the multi-purpose of those little Jagdterriers. Also, although the Pattedale Terrier is a specialist Ur Terrier, it's also very good at catching. Being below ground or above ground, if you catch, it won't release it easily. So that's good, especially if it's such a small frame. It helps a lot if the dogs hang on, so the dispatch can be easier made, and that is also a really nice benefit. The musculature and explosiveness of the Pattedale Terrier is also a big pro. Jagdterriers are more like a taunt type of dog, so more baying, attacking, releasing, smart fighters in that case, that they don't take all the damage. But can also be detrimental. For example, if they just latch on to the first thing that they see, often they focus the paws, which works wonders with hawks, but it's not as good against foxes or badger, because if it catches onto a paw and the badger or the big male fox goes to work on its head or its eyes or its nose, this is not a good thing. Also, you could think about even when you add a Pattedale Terrier to a Whippet frame, you get a dog which looks quite a bit like a Jacht Terrier in its snout. So the snout of the Pattedale Terrier will be a little bit elongated, so more length. Whereas if you go to the Jacht Terrier Whippet cross, the snout will be quite lengthy. And a lengthy snout has benefits for air and all the other stuff. And also gives room to a broad set of teeth, but it's not as good for the close combat that sometimes also arises, and also has a bigger chance of being fractured or hurt in other ways. Because of the additional reach, they are not so good for fighting and keeping in a neck hold or a nose hold as compared to this sturdier snout, as you can see in this Pattedale Terrier here. I hope you like this video. Leave comments and we can reply to that. Have a nice day and take care all.